You are tuning in to the Atlanta Realtors Rundown, the official podcast for the Atlanta Realtors. We're here to keep you updated with the latest trends, topics, and keep you in the know of our ever-changing Atlanta market. We hope you enjoy this episode.
Welcome back. It's your host, Kate Wright, and I have the privilege of having an episode with my dear friends, Michelle Doherty and Amanda Lott, who I have gotten to know through YPN. And today we have the opportunity to discuss some of the ways that YPN has led to leadership opportunities and really refined us in our business. So to get us started, I would love for the girls to introduce themselves, share a little bit about your journey getting involved into YPN and starting as a realtor. I think it's very important to hear kind of how both of you got into the industry and really just kind of lead us into your YPN journey. Amanda, do you want to start?
Absolutely. So I'm Amanda Lott. I'm from Memphis, Tennessee, and I'm currently your immediate past chair for the Young Professionals Network Advisory Board of NAR. I started in real estate back in 2008 because I was a visionary, and I'm a second generation realtor. So when I first got in the business, things were quite different. But being a second generation realtor and coming from someone that was highly involved in a local and state level, engagement and involvement was preached to me from day one. At the time, we did not have YPN. It did not exist, but it was in the making. And so around 2011 is when I started having conversations with my local about just the realization that the majority of our industry was not me. I didn't see myself represented in that industry, but I had to have known that there were some out there. So we decided that there was a need for a group for the handful of younger agents that existed in our association to have a place to feel welcome, because when you're in an industry where the average age is 55 and you come in new or young, it's very easy to feel intimidated. So I got with my local to do the YPN out of a need that I saw for just feeling engaged and plugged in. Where it went from there is a whole other journey.
I love it. All right. How about you, Michelle?
Well, I kind of fell into real estate right after college. I started working with a large team, and it was great, but I was trying to build the business that I saw amongst my brokerage, which the brokerage I was with was on the older side. And it was myself and my best friend in the office was this gentleman who was 83 years old. Him and I were coming in every single day to the office, him because he didn't have a computer at home, and me because I was trying to build a business. And he was an amazing resource of, you know, the last 40 years in the industry.
Wow.
But at the same time, I was like, if I don't get friends in who are realtors or working in the real estate profession my age, I don't think I can stay in this business for much longer. I love Tom Boyle, but I'm really tired of having the early bird special every day with him. And I need to be able to be like, hey, do you want to go grab a drink and just like vent about how tough this spring market is, or how you are really converting clients from open houses and that kind of stuff. And that's what YPN was for me. And for me, getting to the YPN was funny. I had to be basically like coaxed into going, because I firmly believed before I got involved that you only went to the association to get in trouble and to get your lockboxes. And that was it. Nothing more than that. And then I went to that one YPN meeting, and now they can't get me out of that association building. So a lot has changed since then. And that was end of 2015, early 2016. So, yes.
Awesome. And before we go any further, will you let everyone on the podcast know what your role is within YPN?
So I am the 2023 NAR YPN Vice Chair and next year's 2024 YPN Chair.
So you're somebody that our upcoming YPN people are going to be up under your leadership and benefiting. And I had the benefit of being up under Amanda's leadership. So I just want to make sure everybody knew that we've got these rock stars on the podcast today. You guys are amazing. You're legendary. So getting involved in YPN was the first kind of segue for both of you into involvement with your realtor organization. Once you started attending these things, it sounds like you felt like you kind of had a place, and it was somewhere where you could engage, somewhere where you felt welcomed, and somewhere where your efforts and your energy and the business that you were trying to build could kind of come together. How did you start to
engage on a level where you somehow were led into a leadership opportunity through YPN? So I think one of the unique things with YPN is, one, we're all inclusive and we're the most welcoming group that I think I've ever been a part of. But we also have our hand in just about everything. So the leadership opportunities and growth opportunities within YPN as a network were wonderful, but the opportunities outside of that are also what have been probably the most beneficial for me and my business. But moving through YPN leadership, you start to, you hear, you observe, you watch, you network, you meet. That is what we are, is a network. And being plugged into things like MLS, and all of a sudden, oh, well, I'm going to sit on the MLS committee locally or at state or wherever you can get in to learn more about that. All right, is that my thing? Well, maybe not. The wonderful thing about being a YPNer is that your association, typically local or state, wants you, needs you, and will put you just about anywhere. If you ask, you just need to ask.
And show up.
Yes, and show up. Please show up. Don't just say, I want to be involved, and then you're like, this isn't for me. You've committed for the year. See it out through the year and make sure that you give it your all so that you can really say, yes, this is what I want to be a part of, or no, it's not. But I would say it probably, I wasn't originally my chair when I started our local YPN because my mom was going to be the president at the time. And before Nepo Baby was a thing, we still knew even then probably wasn't the greatest look, just not something that we needed to do. Plus, one of us had to hold down the fort as far as business. We could only, one of us could be in charge at a time, not both of us.
Right.
So she went the presidency route. I stayed on YPN committee to help see it through. And then when I became president, I think 2 or 3 years into it, you know, we had some fallout. I stayed president for a year or two. And then from there, I got engaged into the board of directors, and I got engaged into MLS, and I got engaged into state on professional standards. And I thought that was probably where that was going to end. And then on a whim, I decided to submit my application for NAR, not really thinking that that was going to go anywhere. And here we are 5 years later, and the trip has been, the journey has been absolutely more than I could have ever imagined.
So you started getting involved with your local YPN. You stayed engaged. It led to opportunities for local leadership, which likely also opened doors for state leadership. You fulfilled all of your commitments there, and then the door opened for an opportunity with the National Association of Realtors.
Absolutely. Showing up is half of the battle.
Correct. How about you, Michelle?
So mine was a little different. So I was super involved with my local. I was chair of my local YPN in 2019, but I applied at the end of 2018, early 2019. I submitted my application for 30 Under 30, Realtor Magazine's 30 Under 30. It was my last year to get it. And by the skin of my teeth, I became one of the top 30 Under 30 for 2019. And that was the catalyst, if you will. I then applied in May in 2019 to be on YPN, be on whatever committees they would take me on at NAR. And because I wanted to explore more, and we didn't have a state YPN at the time. And I wanted more of that engagement across the nation because of the 30 Under 30 crew. I mean, I was like, oh my gosh, I need more of this. It was just, you left every single time being with when NAR was here for mid-year, or when I got to do the 30 Under 30 meetups, you just left on fire. And I was like a junkie. I needed more of that. I needed more of that energy. I needed more of that inspiration. I needed more of that leadership because it was so inspiring to be around and just lit this fire within my belly that like was so desperate to see others in a like-minded age doing the kind of business I wanted to do.
Right. So your opportunities came from getting involved in local leadership with YPN. And engaging in your market and networking through YPN as well. Yeah, I remember I got tapped on the shoulder at my local association in the summer of 2016. And it was Bill Rawlings who came and said, I want you to be the YPN chair next year. And I had never had an opportunity to be in any leadership before. I had just finished our Emerging Leaders program. So it does now make sense. But at the time it didn't. I was like, wow, how did I get this opportunity? And I remember I didn't even have to think about it. I was like, yes. And like 2 days later, I found out I was pregnant with my first kid.
Oh my gosh.
And I was like, I can't let Bill down.
Oh.
So I was like, I got to do it anyway. And I had Sophia in January, my first child in January. And I was starting my stint as the YPN chair right as I was having my first baby. But let me tell you, I was so honored to have the opportunity.
and I was not going to let anyone down, that I was like, I will show up.
I know. It is that, like, I'm not going to let you guys down. I will, at least my body will be physically there.
Yes. And I think part of what made me, similar to you, Michelle, and you probably have felt it too, Amanda, what made me feel so indebted in a way to YPN was the feeling that I had when I did get the opportunity to go to Advance for the first time in Chicago. So our local had been doing YPN. It had been going well. We had great energy around it, but I had never yet been around YPNers from across the country. And when I went to Chicago, I had no idea what I was walking into, and my mind was blown. I got to meet the most amazing people from across the country. They had the best ideas, the most energy, and they were producing really great results. And so I remember leaving there, like, going back to my local and being like, you guys, you gotta hear this. And they're all like, great, I'm glad you went. So after getting that fire ignited in me and in Chicago at the Advance, and having the opportunity, not 30 under 30, but to be around the YPN leaders from across the country, and to learn from the leaders who had come before us that were leading on the advisory board, I was blown away. And I was like, I will make this as great as I can. So that commitment that I made to YPN also led me into a slew of other opportunities that I didn't even ask for. But when given the opportunity, and I think a lot of YPNers would say this, when given an opportunity to do something in leadership, we tend to say yes.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And so I think it's interesting to kind of circle back and go to the beginning of that leadership journey that started in YPN and hear your story, Amanda, hear your story, Michelle, but also just to kind of discuss some of the ways that it did force you or mature you in your business,
mm-hmm.
and things that it did to benefit you when you did show up when it might have been hard. Like, having a new baby and then being in charge of something for the first time was, like, really overwhelming, but the hardness is what made it great for me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I would be curious to hear a little bit about what you think YPN has done for you, more on a personal note and professional note, and your leadership development journey.
Mm-hmm. Growth for me has been exponential during the YPN experience. Partly personal stuff, you know, I mean, going through YPN all these years, there were a couple years that I did dip out and wasn't engaged, got pregnant and had a baby, focused on that, let YPN do its thing on a local level, kind of checked out of leadership altogether around 2011, 12, and 13, and then became re-engaged again. That happens, like, and that's okay. You don't have to be everything to all the people all the time. That's something I've learned from my YPN friends locally and nationally, that you don't have to be everything to everybody, but it is a good idea on this journey to leave yourself open for possibilities. Whatever you think your leadership trajectory does or doesn't look like is more than likely not how it's going to go either way. And what you think you might be on the path for, other people may see other things in you that you just don't see yet.
Hmm.
And continuing to be engaged and continuing to surround yourself with people that are also on a just growth leadership journey is going to help you figure that out. YPN personally has meant so much to me in my career. You know, being involved and being engaged does improve your business and does make you more money, whether you realize it or not. It's very hard to understand at the beginning, but when you look back, these connections and these conversations, and these connections as far as referrals also, I mean, there's an obvious, clear monetary, you know, achievement from this, but, the growth that you have within your business of learning different tips, tricks, talking to people about how this is how I handled this, this is how I handled that, that you wouldn't necessarily always get from your local necessarily. That is where I've seen the growth of being plugged in and engaged on the national level, is just having these wonderful women like y'all sitting around here right now that have continued to see me through and help me grow and get me to where I need to be, where y'all see that I need to be that I don't always see.
I got that. Well, for me, it's what kept me in the business. And I think for me, I mean, it's given me a life that I didn't think I could have as a single woman. I didn't think I could purchase a home. You know, I was brought up to believe, like, you buy a home if you get married. I bought a couple homes before I got married, or I'm about to get married. And, you know, YPN kind of reconnected me with my soon-to-be husband, because we grew up on the same street, but I didn't know he was a mortgage lender. He didn't know I was a realtor.
We have a lot of YPN love stories. And
A lot of YPN love stories. A lot of happy marriages.
Yeah.
And tons of YPN babies.
Yeah.
So yeah, shout out to Krista and Phil Becker in San Antonio if you ever need a realtor down there. It truly has given me a life that has exceeded my wildest dreams and hopes for myself. And for me, it's, you know, in the roughest of times, your YPN family will be there for you, because if you show up for them, they're showing up for you in your darkest days. I promise you that. That is 100% non-negotiable. It happens. So it's been my safe haven, my home, a place where I know I can turn to on a good day, bad day, or otherwise. And also, the innovation that comes from these amazing YPNers is insane. Some of them, maybe in the moment, like they're working on new technology that I'm like, I don't know. But I bet you in 2.5 years, everybody's been using this technology. You know what I mean? So it's like the innovation, the ideas, the, you know, want to make this profession, because that's what it is, better from what we provide to our clients to how we show up in the communities. It's just inspiring. And I'm really, I don't know if I'll ever let go of YPN, because I'll be the washed up has been.
Yeah, I won't let go.
In a wheelchair, being wheeled in to a YPN meeting at annual. But
back in my day.
Yeah. I'll do it. I'll be there in the back of the room wearing a YPN, you know, t-shirt.
About the blood.
Yeah.
And just like we have. I mean, when we had our meeting the other day, there's so many people that walk through that you're like, you haven't been on the AB for, I don't know, 6-7 years, but you're still one of us for our
audit.
And you want to be there. You want to hear what's going on.
And they want it to be even better than the year previously. So yeah, that's what it means to me.
I think that, not that I ask myself this question, but YPN really honed my leadership, because just having moments where you realize people do look to you or look to that space for community and the responsibility that you feel for providing that to them. You know, like YPN is such, like we've talked about, such a welcoming place, such a community feel. And it's so collaborative, but like having the opportunity to lead a group like that to me felt like such a responsibility that I was like, I want to take this as far as I can possibly take this, beyond just what I can do for my local, but how can I help at my state level? How can I help on a national level? And I too had the opportunity. I haven't been in the leadership role at the head of the table in national YPN, but to be on the advisory board was like such an honor. And I don't think that I ever would have got there had I not just started with YPN and genuinely cared about it.
Yes.
I never sought out at the beginning to have leadership opportunities.
Right.
I was just like, I care about this. I care about the people. I care about the mission and the community and the collaboration.
And I want to make friends and have a good time.
Yeah. And I want us to be able to co-op together. And I want to be able to, you know, figure out what are you doing in your market? And what are you doing that's working in your business planning? And, you know, are we crazy for this? Because that's what a lot of what we do. Are we crazy? And just have that community and to be able to grow in that space, which naturally let all of us out of it, yet we haven't really left. So, you know, it's neat to me that the engagement that originally just started as a local, okay, I'll go to this, propelled each of us to this table. And I didn't mention this earlier. They might be able to hear it on the recording, but we are in Washington, D.C. right now at our NAR mid-year meetings. And to be able to come together a few times a year with all these people, whether you're in a leadership position or not, but just to be able to come with people from across the entire country who care on a deep level about what they do and who are invested in our industry, investing in RPAC, investing within their local, investing within their state. It's just next level.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And to have a group that you know that you can come to if you are, you know, say a younger person, and we say young at heart, it's not like there's an age gap on or age cap on this. Like Michelle's coming when she's in a wheelchair. So
right.
If you want to come, we welcome you. But to know that we can bring this group together and that we have these opportunities that span outside of just your neighborhood is so amazing. And there's a lot of people who don't even know it exists.
Exactly.
So, you know, my mission and my goal locally is to make sure that people understand that, like, there's a huge network outside of us. There's a huge
of some really, really smart people
who want to give,
that want to give and share their ideas and what they're doing and what they're working on. Because one, odds are you're probably not going to take it home and do it, because we all have that tendency. But even if you did, they genuinely want you to be successful. Take it.
Right.
Take my information.
Right.
Go copy this in your market. Do what I'm doing where you are. That's right. What they want. No one
No one, what's the word, gatekeeps? We don't gatekeep our information.
No, we share.
Want you to all be successful. That's the goal.
I'm sitting here, you're saying that, and I'm literally looking at my screen, and I have a Cokie's listing packets right here on my screen. So, I mean, it's like the most collaborative, generous group of people.
Yes.
And it's not fake. Like, you would never brag on yourselves, but here we go. We got a 30 under 30. Michelle is in DC. She rocks this market. Amanda's in Memphis. She crushes it. If you follow her and you just see one of her modest little posts, you'd be mind blown with the amount of production that she can. I don't know how she does it all. These are the people that are the real deal. It's not fluff. This is not smoke and mirrors. And I think that's another thing that I really appreciate about YPN is that it's not just like, oh, yeah, we all come together and have a few drinks and chat. Like, these are people who are performing in their market. Mm-hmm. They are people who are making change in our industry. And we mentioned it once. We'll mention it again. I'll mention it five more times. They're so generous.
Yes, a very generous group, very loving, very giving mm-hmm. Of their time, of their resources. It's the best community that we have.
Yeah. And I know Michelle kind of hit on this, but it's such a hard industry that we work in and it can feel so isolating. You know, you work for most of us for ourselves, by ourselves. And having that group of people locally, at the state level, national level, even just in your office, even if it's not your YPN friends, just having that core group of people who do what you do, who understand the daily struggle, who are on the grind and can, I don't want to say commiserate, but who can relate to you are the people that you have to go out of your way and intentionally set up those relationships so that you can survive in this industry. There's a lot of people who come in to real estate and they don't make it past 2 years.
Exactly.
Yeah, most of them don't. Overall, it's cooperation over competition all day, every day. Collaboration over competition. Mm-hmm. Yes, we are competitors, even in our local market, especially in our local market, competitors technically. But that is in no way, shape, or form what 99% of our realtors operate as. Mm-hmm. We collaborate, we love, we give, we share. We want to see the best for everybody. There's enough to go around.
But part of
it always has been.
Right. And part of that collaboration is having the opportunity to have that friend on the other side of the transaction. Mm-hmm. To know that they're trustworthy, to know that they've shown up, to know that they're committed to your industry, to know that they invest in ARPAC. It's like we have that like-mindedness, and now this transaction is likely going to be a lot easier.
Yes, and outside of your local, being able to send customers, clients, friends most of the time mm-hmm. to somebody that you know is going to take care of them.
100%. Right? And make you look good.
Yeah.
When you can make a referral to someone that you do know through the National Association of Realtors, not just like, oh, I looked on the computer and Googled these three agents.
Right.
When you're like, hey, my friend Yurette in Vegas is going to take care of you. She's my dear friend. You've probably seen her in my pictures. We see each other 3 or 4 times a year. We talk all the time. I don't even have to pick up the phone and check, hey, how's everything going? I already know it's going to be amazing. And they're going to be texting me telling me, we love her. She's so great. So that's another benefit that we really didn't hit on before, or heavy, but it's a huge benefit.
And oh, yeah. There's a networking opportunity there that will make your life so much easier and mm-hmm. just elevate your business to the next level with if you're working towards a referral base.
Oh, absolutely. And your reputation.
Yeah.
Right. So, you know, there's so much that YPN has and can offer and give. But, you know, I think I kind of said it a second ago, but the onus is on you. Mm-hmm. You know, you got to show up and decide that you're going to do this and you got to commit to it just like you've got to commit to real estate. When you're a new agent, if you're like, well, my first year sucked, well, you didn't give it enough time. You didn't have to look
yourself. You got to look yourself.
You got to look at yourself in the mirror. And so if this is something that you hear this podcast or you hear about these relationships and you're not feeling them, or you're like, I haven't experienced that, or how do I get involved? This is a perfect opportunity for you to look in the mirror and say, I'm going to do this. I'm going to commit to it. I'm going to give it my all. Even when I feel like it might not be working, even when I'm wondering if these, you know, relationships are really going to bloom.
Right.
Following through. Because if I hadn't followed through with YPN, I don't even think that, I mean, I wouldn't even know y'all.
Oh, no.
I don't know that we ever would have.
No.
If it wasn't for
YPN. Well, I thought you hated me, Amanda.
Most everybody does. I don't, though.
She hated me when I first met her.
Most everybody does. I remember the first time I saw you.
Yeah.
It was at Advance.
Yeah.
Harrison Beecher came up and gave you a big hug.
Yeah.
I was like, okay, so we know her. We like her. But I just remember your outfit. And I was like, I feel like I need to get to know her because I love her.
You were so serious. And I was like, I don't think she's going to like her. Not typically very serious looking and acting people are like, good God, get her away from me. But here we are.
Here we are.
But even more special how each of us are so unique and so different.
No, yeah.
And I think, you know, a lot of people nowadays, everything can feel very divisive and just isolating and just, I don't know, tense.
Yes.
I mean, we are some of the things that we believe in, care about,
the way we vote. Everything is so different.
Oh, very much.
Such sweet friends. Yes. And it's so valuable to me. I would love for everybody to have some type of an experience. And it's not just for girls. I know it's us ladies who are sitting here.
Yes, but it's not.
But there are a lot of men who are part of this. We should have brought some of them in on the conversation.
Sure, I know. It's like, it sounds very lady heavy.
It does. Like, we're just like a little adult sorority over here.
Not at all. Not at all.
No, we have, we've got Jairo Rodriguez from New Jersey mm-hmm. at the helm currently.
And he's one of the gals.
Yeah. Oh, no, he's not. He's a veteran.
No, he's a badass.
He is a badass. Rob Reuter is the godfather. You know, we always have to have the masculine influence in our world to keep things balanced.
Yes, not just the ladies. We need the guy leaders too, and they are protectors of us. They're just good. They're really good guys, and they're really good girls in this group.
Yeah.
So you know, I'll kind of end this episode by saying, I would love for anyone listening to it to reach out. If you're an older agent, you feel like you don't really have a place, look for someone in your office that might be younger that needs a place and encourage them to come. Don't be shy. I think that's another important thing. Is
yeah.
No one is nearly as intimidating as they look, Amanda. But just say hi. I mean, it's not a problem for me. It's not a struggle for me to do that. And so I have to remind myself that for some people it is.
Yes.
But we've mentioned it. I know we're beating a dead horse. We're the most fun, friendly group. And at a local level, if you guys see me anywhere, I am happy to plug you in and engage with you. If you want to come to a state conference, you can be my shadow. If you want to come to a national conference, you can be my shadow. Sometimes it takes that for some people, just
100%.
Needing to have somebody that they can kind of follow around until they feel like they have the ropes and they've met enough people. And anyone at this table, and mostly anyone I know that's involved with YPN on that national level, would do that. And so
yeah, I would don't be scared. I'm an introvert by nature. That's what I am. Peopling is hard for me, but it's important and it's necessary for my business. And over time, it has gotten much easier and dare I say enjoyable. Dare I say enjoyable.
You may have spoken way too soon.
I know, right? I know. I still have a couple more days this week, but it's okay to be scared, but don't let fear dictate what your next move is.
Ooh.
Trust in yourself. Just get out there and do it. It'll help.
A word, a mic drop. Mm-hmm. We should probably just go out on that. But yeah,
for real,
I'm going to end it on this. Thank you, ladies, so very much. There's a million people in addition to you all that I would love to bring on here that are excellent representation of YPN. But I thought it would be nice to have some of our fearless leaders. I know, Amanda, by the time anyone's listening to this, you
yes.
have come to visit us at ARA. What a blessing. And
live and in person, you can be the judge as to whether or not I'm as scary as I look.
She's not. And so I just want to thank everyone who does take the time to listen to this. And I hope that something about it might have inspired you or inspired you to tap somebody else that you see on the shoulder to start getting involved in YPN. Come out, check us out. Let it be your path to leadership. Let it be your path to better yourself in the business. It's an investment that you can make in yourself, both personally and professionally. And so I thank you both for your time. You guys are extremely valuable. If anyone does have any referrals in the DC or Memphis area, they now know who to call.
Yes, we am.
And I will be seeing you all around at our legislative meetings for the next few days.
Yes.
As a part tonight with all of our elected officials.
Woo-hoo. It'd be super fun.
Thank you, ladies.
Thank you for tuning in to the Atlanta Realtors Rundown. Please subscribe, and for more information on how to get engaged, check us out at atlantarealtors.com. We look forward to having you join us for the next episode.